rimasto?
Sto
Cosa? Cosa? Cosa?
Cosa?
Cosa?
Cosa? Cosa?
Cosa?
Cosa?
On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three French hen, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three French hens, two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Yeah. Irene Benoit. Irene Benoit. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me five gold rings.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me.
No! No! Five gold rings!
If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why? Oh, why can't
coronavirus.
eight, three, two.
What's this? Wait a minute. I discovered gravity.
Ooh.
Try it one more time.
Wait.
I'm going to keep it rolling. Just stay there and stop people coming through. Just stop.
Oh,
stop
I'm
people.
Going to go.
You've got like 30 seconds. Remember, she can't find. Just stop people coming through the door.
You want to try it?
No, go through the other side, Ewan, and just wait.
Ava has to go.
Here we go. Yeah. No, she doesn't. She's fine for 30 seconds.
Come, Patricia, try and make this catch good.
Yeah, wait. Ooh.
What's this? Wait a minute. I discovered graffiti.
Ooh.
I can't be sure we didn't get a double back.
Almost keep your feet in the same spot where they are. That applies to you all. Three, two.
Whoa! The wind's too strong. If only we had more Lego to reinforce our house.
We're not doing that. It's appealing for money.
No, you're doing
it.
Yeah.
It's the thing that we
did
outside.
Oh, yeah.
It's
really
tough.
You were outside. Answer,
because he wasn't that sure.
Do you need more practice?
You want to do it.
Listen, there's one of me and five groups, and I'm going to go around and film all the bits.
Listen, sir.
Do you need more practice time?
It's the same thing.
Do you need more practice time?
Yeah, he's just constant.
You understand what I'm after here, don't you?
Yeah.
At the moment, they've got the final appeal for money. We haven't even started the 1 minute science thing, yeah, have we?
It's not racist at all, no, not at all. It comes from China. China.
Three, two, try not to shake your legs. Three, two.
If only you could give us some money to reinforce our house.
If you give us...
What?
You got
it at the wrong bit.
No, but we're only doing this bit.
Thank you.
A vet.
Probably a footballer.
Playing for Tottenham Hotspur.
An author.
Footballer or boxer.
A cook.
A professional footballer.
A famous rugby player.
Being a professional footballer for Man U.
I'm 11 years old, not even thought about a career yet.
A hairdresser.
EA sports player.
A pediatric oncologist.
Probably a streamer or a YouTuber because I like to play on Xbox and a variety of games, so I just feel like that'd be the job for me.
My dream job is to be a writer.
Being a YouTuber / streamer.
Being Olympic gymnast and a runner.
Probably to be a pig farmer.
Probably an actor.
An engineer.
An actor.
My dream job is to play for the England's women team in football.
My dream job is to be a clothing designer.
My dream job's either a professional footballer or a PE teacher in a school.
I think I'm going to try and achieve a vet, so I won't have a backup plan.
Maybe a teacher.
Playing in Chinese League.
A teacher.
Something to do with cars.
I really want to be a cook.
A dryliner with my dad.
A PE teacher.
Homeless.
Probably working at Primark.
I don't need a backup plan. I'm going to be in the sports player.
A pediatric oncologist.
Probably an editor or a cameraman because I like filming and I like editing videos and movies and all that.
Probably a professional skateboarder.
Being a YouTuber.
Be working at McDonald's.
A teacher. My backup plan will probably be on the other side of the camera as a director.
An engineer.
A KFC worker.
I want to be a doctor.
I haven't got a plan B, that is what I'm going to do.
Plan B, yeah, I would be a professional footballer.
I think Emily, Vanessa, and there's a lot more, but I would go on forever.
Harriet, Vanessa, and Tori.
Harry, Ewan, and Seth, because they've been with me from the start.
My best friends are Tori, Lauren, and Lisa because they've always been really kind to me. And
Oliver, Alex, Seth, and Harry just because they're easy to talk to and they're just good laugh.
Lewis, Harry, and Ethan because I always play with them.
Alex, Billy, and Seth because they're really funny and fun.
Lily, Tori and Zoe, because they've been my friends since I can remember.
Oliver, Billy and Michael Yankoi because they're always there to help me and always being the best friends that I've had.
Jacob, Riley and Ewan because they've just been there for as long as I can remember.
Probably Ava was my best friend throughout school because she's always been there for me and she understands me.
Milo, because we like to geek out about our favourite anime.
Lauren, Harriet and Patricia. Lauren and Harriet have been my best friends since Red Unit. And Patricia because she's just really loving, kind and funny.
Ewan, Lucas and Ethan. Ewan because we've been friends since Red Unit and he's overall just a nice person. Ethan and Lucas because they're funny and they're very intrigued to do like what you want to do. And they're funny and whenever you're down they just come and help you. So same with Ewan, they're overall a nice person.
My best friends are Lily, Ertie and Jack because they have always been kind to me and they're literally amazing.
Riley, Ethan and Jacob because they always make me laugh.
Lily Webb because she's just there when I need her. Kate because she's just so funny. And Harriet, she's just gives you humour.
Zoe, Abisha and Lily because they've been through a lot with me and they're really kind to me.
There's absolutely far too many to choose from.
Kate, because I share lots of things with her.
Ertie, Lily and Olivia Hayter because they've been with me my whole life.
I think my best friends are Emily, Lisa and Lily because since the beginning of foundation we've all been friends.
My best friends are Joshua, Harriet and Emily. Joshua because he was my first friend, Harriet because she's always there for me and Emily because she always makes me laugh.
Mikey is my best friend because first day I came into St. Bede's, we just connected, became friends. We've been friends since. And Harry, because I've been friends with him since year one, and he's one of my friends because he does sports. He's like me, footballer. He likes other sports as well. And Ethan, because he's a funny person. He's good at football. He likes football. He's a good mathematician. Bartek, because he's just the funniest in the class, he's a class clown. He always just tells us funny jokes, and he's just funny, it's just what he does best.
Mrs. McCormack, because she's harsh, but she's funny at the same time.
Mr. Belmont because he's helped me loads and he's helped me get through everything.
Mr. Freeman because he has like taught me how to do sport.
Mrs. Gallagher because she's been in every single class, well nearly every single class I've been in, and she's been a really nice teacher. And
Mr. Freeman, because he's a good teacher and easy to have a laugh with.
Mr. Freeman.
Mr. Freeman, Mr. and Mr. Sharp, because they're funny and they're just really funny and they like sports.
I like Miss McCormack because she helped me get through class 7 and class 9.
Mr. Freeman, because he always helped me to be training for football and keeping me fit.
Mr. Freeman, because he just does loads of sports and he helped me with my writing.
Miss Jenkinson, because she's helped me through everything, dancing, singing and everything with my education.
Mr. Sharp, because he's nice.
Mrs. Shaw, because she's really funny and she's kind and she gives me big hugs.
My favourite member of staff would be Mr. Freeman because I like doing sports and he's a very sporty teacher, and when I were in his class we'd always do like PE like every two times a week or something like that.
My favourite member of staff is Mrs. McDowell because she got me through a lot of hard times and she's really kind.
Mrs. McDowell because she helped me get through rough times.
Mrs. Brothler because she was just so funny.
Mrs. Dowell because she's kind and she's been... kind. Mr. Freeman, because at the start of St. Bede, he was there for me and he really helped me to get to know the place.
Mrs. McDowell, because she helps me do everything.
Either Mr. Freeman, because he helped me like sports more, or Mr. Sharp, because he inspired me to do art.
This is a very hard one. It's either Miss McCormack or Mr. Freeman, because Miss McCormack helped me in class 7 and class 9, and she made it really fun. And Mr. Freeman's helped most people progress in their sports.
My favourite member of staff is Mrs. McCormack, because she's the one who pushed me the most with the thing I struggle with, which is spellings.
Mr. Freeman, because he's taught me and my brother, and he's a nice teacher, he's a sports teacher and I like that, and yeah.
Probably the enrichment day in the woodlands, because we just got like super messy.
My favourite memory is Whitby, because we got to do stuff on our own and we got to do lots of things.
Going to Whitby because we had fun for 3 days with all my friends.
Probably going to Whitby because it made me more independent and I really liked it.
Whitby or G4S. With me, I underestimated it a lot. It was a great trip, and G4S, we won it, so, yeah.
Whitby.
The Class 5 Assembly, because we got to interview Nelson Mandela.
I liked it when we went to Whitby, because I got to be quite independent.
Whitby, because it was the sleepover, it was just a lot of fun and experiencing a lot of things.
Whitby Residential, because it was just really fun to just have time with your friends and being away from home.
Whitby, because of the people I got to spend it with.
Whitby, because just great.
Probably Whitby, because we got to go shopping on our own, and it was my first time surfing, so.
Probably Whitby, because I felt free and I could chill out with my friends, and because of surfing, and it was just a laugh, and we got to know all the teachers.
My favourite memory of school was the 150 Years Garden Party, because that day was really fun for me and I enjoyed that day a lot.
When I became deputy head boy, because it just felt like an achievement.
Padded Hall Farm, because there was a pig giving birth.
Whitby, because I learnt a lot and it was fun.
My best memory would probably be my first day, because when I first got here, I didn't really know anyone, but everybody was really kind and welcoming, and so that was nice to for them to let me fit in.
Whitby, because I've got to spend time with my friends.
Whitby, because it inspired me to be like responsible and an older version of me.
I think my favourite memory of school is Whitby, because we all had independence. We could stay with our friends. Yeah.
My favourite memory of school was going to Whitby, because we got that step up of independence and it was something nice to do with our friends.
Probably, definitely Whitby, because it was just a fun experience and that was the first time I went there and I just enjoyed it.
your favourite food?
Cheese.
Favourite flavour, cheese.
I don't have a favourite flavour of cheese.
Favourite flavour of cheese?
Tough one.
Red Leicester.
I like cheddar cheese. It's delicious.
Mozzarella.
I don't have one.
I don't like cheese.
Cheese.
Cheddar.
Wedgies.
Triangle cheese.
I don't like cheese.
Mozzarella.
Just cheese.
Favourite flavour, cheese.
My favourite flavour of cheese probably is cheddar.
Red Leicester?
Mozzarella.
I don't like cheese.
I don't have one.
What would you do if you won £10 million?
Celebrate.
Favourite animal? Sloth.
If you won £10 million, what would you buy?
I'd probably send me and my family over to Spain, then buy a house at Spain, then because no one else in the house knows how to drive other than my dad, I'd buy my dad a Tesla, and then I'd probably book a cruise to go somewhere, and then because there's that much reasons why, I probably couldn't be able to fit them all in. And the last one would probably just be like probably then splitting my money, but I, you know, I keep some.
Favorite YouTuber?
Bondi Rescue.
My favorite YouTuber is someone called Formula.
Favorite holiday destination?
Banff, although I've never been there.
If you could visit any country that you've not visited yet, where would it be?
Belgium.
Why Belgium? Do you think that's like Brazil or Australia?
Belgium.
I've never heard anybody say Belgium. If you won £10 million on the lottery, what would be the first thing you'd buy?
I'm going to help all my family.
My favourite drink is Dr. Pepper.
Favourite flavour crisps?
Prawn cocktail.
Who do you look up to?
Ronaldo or Rashford.
Favourite hobbies?
Painting and drawing.
What is your favourite food?
Pizza's my favourite food because it's got loads of different flavours and overall it's just a nice food.
Favourite TikTok song? What's the first thing you buy when you get a £50 million Tottenham contract?
Mercedes.
Favourite player?
I like them, Donald.
My favourite crisps is prawn cocktail crisps.
Favourite holiday destination?
Greece.
Favourite iPad app?
Eight ball pool.
If you won £10 million, what would you buy first?
A nice car or a house.
Favourite musical instrument?
Piano.
Favourite TV show?
Sky Sports.
Favourite holiday destination?
Portugal.
What is your favourite colour?
Blue or black, because they're like really dark to me and I just like the colours blue and black. I like blue because it's dark blue, especially because blue just kind of like when I see it, it kind of like motivates me to do what I want to do. And black is because I just like the dark colour on it.
What's been your favourite holiday?
Well, it's Torremolinos.
And what are you going to miss about St. Bede's?
Probably Mr. Sharp's really funny jokes and his opera singing.
Well, what message would you like to leave for Mr. Freeman?
Thank you for taking me to tournaments and helping me with my sports.
Most inspirational footballer?
and Messi.
And I would like to go to New York.
Favourite car?
Lamborghini.
Favourite colour?
Yellow.
Favourite YouTuber?
MTDM.
Favourite football position?
Left wing.
Favourite game?
Fortnite.
What's your favourite food?
Ice cream.
What message would you like to say to Mr. Sharp?
I'll miss you.
Favourite sports brand?
Nike.
What are you most looking forward to about going to St. Bernard's?
Making new friends.
Advice would you give to someone just starting in foundation at St. Bede's?
Be good.
Favourite drink?
Dr. Pepper.
Favourite TV programme?
Peppa Pig.
Favourite flavour crisps?
Ready salt or cheese and onion.
What would you spend on first if you won £1 million?
I wouldn't spend anything, I'd give to charity.
Favourite car?
Probably an Audi.
Favourite car?
A Lamborghini.
What advice would you give to someone just starting at St. Bede's?
Never give up, try your hardest, and soon you'll achieve what you want to achieve.
Favourite drink?
Water.
Favourite crisps?
Prawn cocktail.
Best video game?
Fortnite.
What is your dream holiday destination?
Probably Greece.
Any regrets as you leave St. Bede's?
No.
What would be the first thing you would buy if you won £10 million on the lottery?
A load of pets.
Favourite holiday destination?
Sri Lanka.
Favourite film?
Forward Unto Dawn.
What was it like to be part of the COVID year?
Strange.
Very what fun. Advice would you leave for Miss Gascoigne?
Continue playing the piano.
Trust your legs, little angel. Go again. 3, 2, 1.
Continue playing the piano and teaching children and helping them in their learning in every area.
If you win £1 million, what would be the first thing you buy?
Pepsi.
What's your favourite TV show?
Friends.
My advice for Mr. Freeman is to grow some hair.
If you won £1 million, what would you do?
Give it all to my mum.
That's a beautiful answer.
All? You've been very
good. And that's your answer, well done.
My favourite car is probably a BMW or an Audi.
Favourite car?
Lamborghini.
Favourite car?
Lamborghini.
Favourite car?
Lamborghini.
What's your favourite drink?
I don't have one.
Favourite drink?
Orange juice.
What message would you like or advice would you like to leave to Mrs. Wassell?
Carry on because you're a really good head teacher.
Favourite crisps?
Cheese and onion.
If you won £1 million on the lottery, what would you buy first?
A house.
Best film?
Spider-Man.
If you won £1 million, what would be the first thing you buy?
I'm not quite sure.
What advice would you like to leave for a new starter in foundation?
Make sure you don't get told off.
Favourite item from KFC?
Chicken popcorn.
If you won £10 million on the lottery, what would you spend it on first?
I'll give some to Sri Lanka. Then buy some gifts for my family.
Favourite app computer game?
Minecraft.
Favourite clothing brand?
Nike.
Favourite food?
Curry.
Favourite TV programme?
Don't watch TV.
Favourite sports brand?
Adidas.
Favourite app?
Disney Plus.
What's your favourite food?
Pizza.
If you won £1 million on the lottery, what would be the first thing you buy?
Business.
Favourite sports brand?
Nike.
Favourite car?
Purple.
What advice would you give to someone who's just about to start their first day at St. Bede's? What advice would you give them?
Do not cry, you'll get through it.
Your favourite drink?
Pepsi Max Cherry.
Favourite shop at Meadowhall?
Primark.
Dream holiday destination, where would you like to go?
Hawaii.
Which is the best holiday you've ever had?
Going to Spain.
Favourite item from Primark?
Probably leggings.
Favourite TV programme?
Stranger Things.
Favourite car?
Tesla.
A car?
Ferrari.
What car would you like to drive?
A black Range Rover.
Favourite brand of trainer?
Fila.
Favourite Xbox game?
Warzone.
What advice would you leave for Miss Gascoigne?
Keep doing what you're doing, don't give up.
What message would you leave to Mr. Freeman?
Thank you and for being my teacher and being sporty and doing sports for me. And keep that bald head shiny.
Favourite flavour pot noodle?
I don't like pot noodles.
Oh, get out.
Favourite TV show?
Glee.
Which country would you most like to visit in the world?
Probably America.
Favourite thing from McDonald's?
McChicken sandwich.
Your favourite book?
Don't have one.
If you could go on holiday anywhere in the world, where would it be?
Probably Jamaica.
Your favourite sports star?
This is a very hard one. Definitely not Lizzo.
Favourite YouTuber?
Probably Laserbeam.
If you won £1 million on the lottery, what would be the first thing you would buy?
Probably like a house.
And favourite app?
Probably YouTube.
Ideal dream holiday destination?
Spain or America.
What message would you leave to Mrs. Wassell?
Keep doing what you're doing, you're an excellent head teacher. And yeah.
Dream job?
A hairdresser.
Louder.
A hairdresser!
That's just ridiculous.
Class 4's gonna hear you.
A little louder, not shouting at the top of your voice.
Class 4's gonna hear you. Well, a hairdresser.
No, louder than that, please.
Like, you're in the playground, that's how loud you need
to be. You can't say that about people.
Here we go, nice and loud, here we go. Harriet Hall, dream job?
My favourite member of staff is Mr. Freeman, because, so can I do that again? I just thought, okay, I just did
absolutely
that on.
Absolutely. 3, 2, 1.
My favourite member of staff is Mrs. McDougall.
Favourite holiday?
What?
Favourite holiday?
Wasn't it? Was a holiday. Holiday.
Favourite holiday?
Speak properly.
Enunciate, lad.
Favourite holiday?
Shh, now you've had to pause. Three, now you've had time to think about that, so we'll go again. Ready? Favourite pizza topping?
Just cheese.
Favourite car purple?
I don't have a favourite car.
Do we hair? Yeah? Happy with that? This is going to be a little giggly one. Are we ready? Best friends and why?
Riley, I can't say myself.
It's just funny.
I bet you this is going to go on the bloopers. You did that on purpose.
I did not. You ready? Nice and loud. You can sit upright if you want, feel comfortable.
More locket ladders.
I like it like this, like slouching, like a leg log.
I said leather. I like it like this.
Here we go. Oliver O'Connor. Tell me most of your dream job.
My dream job is to work in Morrison's. No, actually no. My dream job is to play for the England women's team.
At what?
Is that why she said my dream job is to walk in Morrison's?
Little louder, sir.
Homeless!
Not that loud. Just a little louder. Just England team's got a lot of teams like for rugby and football. Golf?
Hockey.
Hockey, right, that helped.
Okay.
This is gonna be a long one. Here we go. Here we go. Tori Musa, dream job.
What's that? Okay. I'm good.
Tori Musa, your dream job.
My dream job is to work. Sorry. Okay, again. Sorry. I'm really sorry. This is gonna be real.
You're leaving in 3 weeks' time, you know.
Get it together.
What the heck was that? Who wants a Man City background, is that correct? Please don't look at me.
Like the badge that you have on your jumper.
That's Manchester United.
Sorry, I said it wrong then.
Do you want Manchester United?
Yes. Not Man City.
Manchester United. And that's on camera now. Here we go then, slight pause after each one. What is your dream job, Vanessa?
Well then.
Is that right? Are you going to say that again? Right, so let's go again.
I'm banging them.
Favourite footballer?
Right, I'm guessing it's Harry. Shouldn't go Harry Kane.
Speak forward enough question. Come on then, Lucas, this time, we'll get it. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Favourite footballer?
Heung-min Son.
Anytime, Sharpie.
Staring at the little green dot. White dot. Smile. Favourite TV programme?
He did
it. Oh, am I speaking? Jeremy Kyle show.
Sugar
word,
butcher spellings.
Lovely answer. My favourite memory of school and why?
My favourite member of school is...
Memory.
Memory. Sorry, oh, what's that? Member.
My favourite memory of school and why?
My...
I keep feet still. 3, 2, 1. Drum. Favourite flavour crisps?
French fries, because... that they have taste.
Flavour, not time. Flavour. Cheese, onion, broccoli, french fries.
Oh, flavour. Oh, what's your favourite flavour of crisp? Cheese and onion, or mine, french fries.
No, thank you. Can we have a football stage here?
Yeah.
And then, hospital here.
Football.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
3, 2, 1.
Our science is boring. We need new equipment. Although our teacher's cool, we need to show commitment. Please, can we have a couple of things? And don't worry, it's not diamonds and rings.
Drones to help us see how high the gravity is.
banana shark. What would you like?
Manual Labour of the Year, 1965. Oh, a bit wobbly there, Ollie. Oh, now here we are. This is a different method. Oh, teamwork. Teamwork.
We're not able to turn it over.
No, not there. Take it back there. Right back to where they're raking, perhaps.
To be your best, you've got to try your best. You've got to do your best. You've got to be your best. To show the best, you've got to try your best. To show the best, you've got to look the best. You've got to best, 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 best.
One, go! Pull!
Come on, come on!
Come on!
Pull!
Bradley!
I can't do it! You can't do it!
Can I do one of it?
Right.